Men in Black, Orion's Belt, a universe in a cat's collar. Thing is, we're getting close to it. Meet 5D, as in the fifth dimension. Humanity's new way to store information in almost just as little space. The smaller and more robust our information storage devices get, the more likely they'll be able to outlive us. And isn't that exactly what we want? For the things we do and the things we say and create and feel to live beyond us? If everything were to remain as is, with our faulty hard drives and flimsy CDs, all the information we have today would degrade, and soon. But what if we thought of a new way to conceptualize information? What if information couldn't just be recorded in three-dimensional space, but what if computers could learn to read information based on the bending of light inside glass? Well, that makes literally no sense. Unless you're a researcher at the UK's University of Southampton. These guys deserve all of the awards because of their sheer ability to conceive of an extra dimension of digital information. In 2013, they successfully created a glass disk that reads data in five dimensions of space. A glass disk that stores information so densely that it retains 3,000 times the information of a normal CD. Oh, and brownie points? According to the university, it'll last something like 13.8 billion years, which is the age of the known universe and three times the age of planet Earth itself, and sustain the blistering heat of 1,000 degrees Celsius. This Blu-ray disk holds 128 gigabytes of data. A glass disk of the same size holds 360 terabytes. That would take up a hard drive the size of my entire body. Here's how this scientific black magic works. Think of it like a normal CD. A normal, everyday, household CD is just a bunch of lines in a circle. Each line has a bump, and each bump gets read by a laser as a one, a yes, a on. No bump means zero, no, off. These two dimensions, on and off, are binary code, the language of every computer ever at its most basic. These glass disks shatter those bumps and stack them into three layers to make a nanostructure only lasers can read. Creating these three dimensions of X, Y, and Z is what makes storing this mind-boggling amount of data even possible. And they call it nanograding, which I think sounds like a weapon in a Star Trek flick. They place nanoscale dots so precisely that they can sit in different orientations, making the light refract off of them in different directions entirely, and at different polarized intensities. Some dots let in a ton of light, and other dots, not so much. With a special disk reader that is on its way to becoming a commercially viable product, these devices use a powerful microscope and a polarizer to read the data of bumps, stacked up with different degrees letting light through or not. The tech is pretty much perfected at this point. And because glass is an incredibly tough material, it can not only encode anything digital, but survive most any damage that would completely warp any CD or hard drive that exists today, ever. Just to prove it, the researchers at the University of Southampton put copies of the Bible, Isaac Newton's optics, and the UN Declaration of Human Rights on discs already. For today though, the tech that makes these glass Superman crystals isn't cheap, which is what's stopping it from being in your home right now. Though it's always a challenge to get people to adopt new technological formats, this tech is already here. And as it matures, it'll get cheaper and easier for us to make. And that will ultimately make it the more attractive option for the future of information, for the future of us.